Alright, we're back and we're on the play, and this one doesn't have Aether Vial, which is a little bit bogus. It's a bit of an awkward one, and I'm not really sure how to play hands like this, because if we want a lightning bolt turn one, we don't want to take the two life from steam vents. We don't want to telegraph remand or lightning bolt, but if we're playing against pot or affinity and there's a one drop we really need to bolt, then I will regret not bolting. Okay, interesting. Yeah, like for example, I'm pretty happy to have kept up bolt. However, I'd really like to remand because we need to hit land drops. I didn't get a steam vents because it looks like we're playing against burn, yeah. Nice. Amazing draw, actually. I'm going to wait on the remand. We're going to either take two or play a tapped land at some point anyways. I figure there's a good chance we can get through this turn with bolt only. Oh, actually, we're probably playing against Twin, huh? Scalding Tarn and Sulphur Falls. It's a Twin Mirror, yeah? Gotta be. Okay, I think, yeah. We'll do the old draw step Vendilion, I think. This Mistbind Click is gonna struggle to be in play. Yeah, draw step. I'd also be interested in just not playing it, not playing anything. But so we could get a window to Vendilion and stick. So we could Vendilion and also stick. Try to stick Mistbind immediately, but kind of made my bed now, so might just get remanded anyways. Probably is gonna get bolted or electrolyzed. Bolted, yeah, so I don't know. There probably wasn't a way to really play around that too much. And this way we prevented the opponent from... Yikes, man. This matchup's got to be really hard. Klasms are going to help for sure. So one of these pyros is just going to come down, and Snapcaster's a thing too. I don't think we can win this game, honestly. Like, bottom the lightning bolt, I guess. Because it's fuel for the pyros. Wow, the opponent skipped their land drop. That's gonna help us, but it's gonna be especially embarrassing when we lose. When we still lose. Spell Stutter is a great draw. There's not gonna be a one drop to counter. But yeah, that was a huge stroke of luck that I will take. Okay. Two drop. Remand. Okay, does this mean the opponent's got plans to play a one drop too? So we could play Spell Stutter and then try to jam it next turn. But the opponent has a Snapcaster though, so that's not going to happen. Yeah, we'd like to be able to apply some kind of pressure. That's a pretty exciting draw. Tells us not to use our attack edge as well. Which is good info to have. So snap bolt's a thing, and all our remands are gonna get burned. But we need to burn them because we need to dig for lands. Dig for just some way to develop our board position, you know? Okay. Alright, well, I don't mind bolting this guy. And then we'll see what we draw on our turn. Hopefully, like a Pestermite. Fairy Conclave is interesting. Fairy Conclave is pretty interesting. Depending on how the opponent plays it, we might be able to spell stutter to counter. No, we're not going to be able to. Oh, okay. Alright, I'm interested in going for this. Animate this. I don't know if I did this out of order. I guess I should have played the Spell Stutter in case it gets condescended for one or whatever. Or if mana leaked, I'd play it the same, so it doesn't make a huge difference. It might have been better the other way, but I doubt that it matters. Because we have nothing else to do with our 2 mana anyways, except for this Tech Edge, which I don't want to use yet. Vapor Snag. That's definitely annoying. However, we can get Kiki down, and then we have our Sprite potentially protected. Okay. Using Scalding Tarn seems smart. Like, might as well save life. Cascade can hook us up with the manas. And then we have a Kiki in play. Okay, so Kiki Spell Stutter verse. I'm gonna attack because I don't want to trade. Although there'd be points for not attacking, hoping the opponent doesn't attack. Because I don't. If we both stayed at 17, that'd be best. I'd say, because we have an infinite combo and the opponent doesn't. So if everyone has 1,000 life, we're heavily favored, right? More life for both players, the better. This type of matchup guides our play. Alright, so the opponent has a Snapcaster that we know about only, yeah. And is playing a very, very slow, man. Okay, here we are. I can't tell if he's like dipping off like the other guy. Okay. Yeah, so our Kiki's kind of like got hexproof or something. Yeah, this Mistbind has been rotting in our hand for so long. We're close to being able to play it. Lightning Bolt. Yuck. Oh wow, is this opponent letting this happen? Well, I guess it doesn't matter, because they have a Snapcaster to do it again. Maybe bottoming Lightning Bolt was wrong. Seems like it probably was. Should have bottomed Snapcaster or something. However, I mean, now the opponent only has one card, so maybe Mistbind Click will do it. We're at the point where we could throw everything on that, you know. If our spread gets bolted, just give it up, potentially. Yeah, so Chasm is definitely going to be our sideboard card. I'm also interested in Scioning it up and moving away from the combo. Remand. Four. Play the Conclave. ship the turn and decide. Don't think I want to go just throw a Mistbind down yet. We've got a little bit of life to work with. Tech Edge seems not that relevant because we can actually use all our mana. See, now would be a time to Mistbind click, but I don't want to do it because if the Spellstutter gets removed, that's just the game. And I don't have a problem waiting one turn so that we have enough mana. I'm paying life. We can use all of our mana this turn, so. Okay. What is my plan? Basically, wait and see. Taking that shock definitely could have been wrong, but we could block with the Conclave or cast a Bolt off that last mana, Pillar of Flame. Gonna bolt that Pyro, which should have already happened. And then Mistbind click. We still have Remand and Conclave as potential options for this turn. I guess I should have left Tech Edge up, but no, that's not an option. We're not gonna. I'm not going to attack Edge. So if something happens to the Spellstutter, we can Mistbind it. Yeah, okay. Let's pick up this Mistbind. And things are not really great when the dust settles, because our life total is dripping lower and lower. Again, this is just not game one. This can't be a good matchup. This gotta be tough. Just Grim Lavamancers and Pokey McPokers. Twin doesn't want to play against this, you know. Okay, I'm not gonna do the math on whether we should play this other vial or not. I'm assuming that we shouldn't. Okay. Hopefully the opponent's drawn two lands. One, two, three, four. Mistbind click. Okay. Bring Conclave to life. Oh, I didn't tap it for mana. Really bad. I meant to do that. Tap it for mana, we have Mutavault as an extra blocker and get to gobble an elemental, and it makes a huge difference. It really does. So, that was bad. Or tapping the vault. I mean, that had been my plan. I didn't really vocalize it, but mistakes happen. Especially on online. Because there's the misclickings and Scion of Una. Alright, well, it's a good draw. Yeah, if we're at three and the opponent's one elemental less, this is maybe a winnable game. Kind of hope to just get lightning bolted because then it would be like, okay, so it doesn't matter, right? Animate this guy. Play a burn spell on a creature. Do it. Okay. Scion of Una. Do we want to block everybody? I shouldn't have played the Scion of Una. We'll go to one. And then get vapor snagged. Yikes. But I think we need the extra pressure. I think that I played this game in general pretty well, actually, but there's a couple, you know, I didn't play it perfect for the entirety of it, that's for sure. Yeah, even called it out. That game was definitely winnable. We were gifted with that extra turn, and I wasn't able to turn it into a victory, so whatever. That's a good match of Magic, and I had fun. Yeah, I think that trying to pestermite Kiki is probably pretty unrealistic, although Kiki seems good. Scion seems much better, and even Kiki with Scion is not horrible. Pestermite, just not. And same with Vendilion, there's just too pointy with no gain. Glenolendras, Clasms, we definitely want as many Clasms as we can get. Spellskite still seems good. Remand seems mediocre. I mean, it was okay, like, it got a couple extra cards at various points. And then we could look at playing Crucible, maybe. Or not playing Mistbind, because this match is just too hard, but we need Fat. Yeah, just attack edging over and over. I don't think this is the matchup where we want to do that. Could play Sowers as well. I think I'm just going to rock it like this. I'm tempted to go down on Mistbinds for sure, but I'm just going to try this.